Pacino, I'm a Pacino, más que nena, más que Pacino. Quiero Pacino, I'm a Pacino, más que nena, más que Pacino. Quiero Pacino, I'm a Pacino, más que nena, más que Pacino. Quiero Pacino, I'm a Pacino, más que nena, más que Pacino.
There's two things I want to say before this match starts. Number one, I'm proud of you, son.
Yeah!
Number two, for those of you who don't know, before TEW, before High Impact, before Rage was ever anything anywhere, there was two guys that no one would book. Two of the craziest people you've ever met in the state. That was Scar, that was Outrage. Now Scar and I did things that no two people should ever do to each other. We set each other on fire, fought and ran each other over a couple of times. We stabbed each other with everything we could find, because to us, deathmatch was wrestling. Tucson has a deathmatch title that has been soiled. The lineage is no longer clean. And because of this, I'm giving TEW 5 months. November, my birthday month. I bring back two things. Number one, the Rage Deathmatch Invitational. And when I say deathmatch, I mean real deathmatch. My kid's been taking tags since he was 12. My kid's been falling on Lego since he was 12. That was 5 years ago. I want grown-ass men to face me in cactus, in gusset plates, in panes of glass, in syringes, and in light tubes. Now, to anyone within the sound of my voice, here in Tucson, in Phoenix, around the United States, if you want in to the Rage Invitational, you get the one belt that will mean deathmatch here in this state. It's not a TEW belt. It's not an Arizona belt. This belt is from my friend Scar, who passed away this year. The only way I know how to give tribute is to put my body on the line and to make it the most violent tournament, to make it look like Slave to the Death Match in Colorado is child's play compared to this. I'm going to bleed buckets for you. I just want five other people. Five people within the sound of my voice. Anyone in that locker, anyone across this country, if you want to step up and bring back real deathmatch to Arizona, the challenge is over.
Yeah!
Although I think the favor will be returned right here, but for right now.
I don't know. He's been here, this is the third time here, he keeps coming back. He's just gonna keep getting better.
Are you serious? Can someone feed him a sandwich or something?
I thought that was
your obviously, Outrage not taking this young man person answer seriously. But as we saw earlier in the event, you can know more than you saw here, going back there to wrestling. That's the one thing about the competition here at Team Kobe.
That's not already. This would be it. Garbage.
See, just like that.
Always it would have been over for Outrage in 3 seconds right there.
I mean, obviously, Outrage, with his experience and with his track record, he's the one favored to win the match here, but all it takes, like you said, is 3 seconds.
Here, hold that.
That's gross.
Hey, watch your fingers when you touch that, Sean Raven.
It's what?
Watch your hands. Pretend like it's 2020.
So Outrage putting out the word about his Invitational Deathmatch coming up. That is going to be unbelievable here at Throwback Era Wrestling. If you haven't seen real deathmatch wrestling, you're going to get all you can handle.
See right there, Outrage is about more than just deathmatch wrestling. Oh, they should take those heavy hands.
Right there.
Those heavy hands. Oh. He doesn't even have to hit it that hard. He just hits it with a little bit of impact, but it'll knock the hell out of him.
Big right hand delivered there by Outrage. Kanta down on one knee. This poor kid's been getting run over since he came into Throwback Era Wrestling. Starting
to feel sorry for him. Well, I mean, it's hard not to feel this sort of thing towards Chris Canton. But then again, this is the rest of the business here, Jeff. Yeah, you gotta prepare for this type of punch.
I love these. next year. It's like the dog chasing the car. What do you do if you catch it?
Well, you put it in the side headlock like he's doing right now.
It looks like there's an opportunity for a submission here. Our referee is checking out. The hole looks clean. Looks good. That is a blood choke. Yeah, that is a, the airway is clear. He's trying to cut off the flow of blood to Outrage's head. The problem is Outrage doesn't need blood in his head.
As much as he's lost. But he's forcing himself right back. Back up really fast as they get to the ropes here, off the ropes. And now, version of the DDT right there, Chris Kent. Kent just got to get on him. One, two. Did you see the bottom of this, Chris? That's how long he's been doing deathmatch wrestling. This isn't even a deathmatch, and he's got thumbtacks in his boots.
Kent is to the outside here. Looks like he's got some kind of a slingshot maneuver in mind here. He's getting ready to fly.
Oh, wait a minute, look at this.
Apex up on the apron. Disrespect there by Kenta.
Oh, but Outrage. That's what he did. Chris Taylor took his eye off the ball. Right here. This is gonna feel good for Shot Saxon, the man who